In this module, we're going to talk about buffers and buffer solutions. And this is part one, because we're going to have a little bit more to say about it in the next part. All right, so first of all, what is a buffer or a buffer solution? Well, it's a solution that you make by combining a weak acid and a salt of its conjugate base, or a weak base and a salt of its conjugate acid. What does that mean? Well, you know, let's say, so what's an example of a weak acid? Well, acetic acid is a weak acid. So if we mix some acetic acid and a salt of its conjugate base, well, what's the conjugate base of acetic acid? Well, if we remove a proton, we have the acetate ion, C2H3O2-, and if we just put some cation on it, so, I don't know, potassium, for example, we have potassium acetate. So a mixture of acetic acid and potassium acetate would make a buffer solution. Now, what does it do? Well, what it does is something that's actually pretty important in a lot of chemistry, including the chemistry in your own body, and that is to keep the pH from changing too dramatically when something acidic or something basic has been added to that solution. And let's go see how that happens. So we're going to start out, first of all, with a buffer solution that we made by combining sodium fluoride and hydrofluoric acid, a weak acid, and a salt of its conjugate base. And let's say we made this solution 1.00 molar in both hydrofluoric acid and sodium fluoride. And what happens if we add a strong acid to it? Well, first of all, the proton from the strong acid will totally dissociate, so it doesn't matter what the strong acid was, nitric acid, hydrochloric acid, what have you. That hydrogen ion, though, will react with the fluoride ion that's in the solution that came from this guy right here, sodium fluoride, because sodium fluoride is soluble in water, so it's really the fluoride ion floating around. And it will combine to make hydrofluoric acid, which is a weak acid. And so essentially what it's done is it's converted a strong acid into a weak acid. And this, notice these arrows, there's an equilibrium because this will dissociate somewhat, but it's the bigger arrow points this way because this equilibrium lies far on the right in this hand equation. So we've taken that proton out and converted it into a weak acid. We've removed a lot of that proton from the solution from when we put the strong acid in, which means we've kept the pH from changing too dramatically. Let's look what happens when we add a strong base. So sodium hydroxide or what have you, something that it's going to produce the hydroxide ion for us. Now, what the hydroxide does is it reacts with the acid, the weak acid that's in this buffer solution. In this case, it's hydrofluoric acid, and it converts this strong base into a weak base. It pulls the proton off of hydrofluoric acid and makes water, leaving behind fluoride, which is a weak base. It's a conjugate base of hydrofluoric acid. Again, in equilibrium, but it lies far, far to the right. So we've pulled that hydroxide out and kept the pH from changing too dramatically. Now let's look at this in a little bit more detail, what happens. Let's set up our good old ice table. So first of all, let's look at the pH. Let's figure out the pH of that buffer solution before we add any extra acid or base to it. So we have an equilibrium, hydrofluoric acid, dissociating the hydrogen ion and fluoride ion. And the Ka it ends up for hydrofluoric acid is 7.1 times 10 to the minus 4th. Now, I'm not going to write this arrow quite like this. I'm going to put our regular old double arrows so nobody gets confused. All right. And we start out with one molar hydrofluoric acid, one molar fluoride ion. And our changes are going to be minus x here, at plus x here, plus x here. We know it's going to shift to the right because Q is equal to zero because of this guy right here. And so there's our equilibrium concentrations. Plug them into our equilibrium constant expression. Solve for X. We get one root that's unreasonable and one root that makes sense. So about 7.1 times 10 to the minus 4th. You get the same answer if you assumed that X was a lot less than 1. Then they cancel here, the ones cancel, and you just have x equals 7.1 times 10 to the minus 4th. Same thing. So anyway, that's x, and that's the hydrogen ion concentration, which gives us negative log base 10 of that, gives us pH of about 3.15. So that's our starting pH. Now, let's add some strong acid to that and see what happens. So let's say we add enough strong acid so that we've added 0.15 moles of the strong acid, and let's keep the volume at the same so we don't have to worry about messing with that. So it's 1 liter still. Well, what's going to happen is, the first thing that will happen when we add this 0.15 moles of the strong acid is what I showed you guys right back here. Right here, it's going to react, the proton from the acid will react to the fluoride ion to make hydrofluoric acid. And then we're going to look at the equilibrium. Now we're going to, let's erase this guy again and put the regular double arrows there. Now our ice table, because we took 0.15 moles of the hydrofluoric acid, or excuse me, of the fluoride ion, combined it with the hydrogen ion, we lost 0.15 moles. So 1 minus 0.15 is 0.85. And we converted that 0.15 moles per liter into hydrofluoric acid. So now we have 1.15 moles per liter of hydrofluoric acid. And remember, we had 7.1 times 10 to the minus 4th moles per liter of the hydrogen ion from before. And now let's set up our ice table, minus X, plus X, plus X. We know it's gonna go this way because, well, Q is gonna be too small. And we have our equilibrium concentrations. Plug in to our equilibrium expression. Solve for X, we get one root that's nonsense, one root that makes sense, and that's X is 2.5 times 10 to the minus 4th. And when we add that to 7.1 times 10 to the minus 4th, notice that we had to include this here, we couldn't say it was zero. We get 9.6 times 10 to the minus 4th molar for our hydrogen ion concentration, which gives a pH of 3.02. Now compare that to what we started with before we added the strong acid, 3.15. Yeah, sure, it went down a little bit, but not nearly as much as if we would just put that same amount of strong acid into an aqueous, 1 liter of an aqueous solution. Because if we calculate that pH, it's just negative log base 10 of 0.15, which is 0.82. That's really acidic, right?